Crate Raiders, man. We raid crates. You know how it goes, man. Crate Raiderz crew out and about, man. Decide to take it a little bit outside the city, you know what I mean? Hit Yaden up, you know what I mean? Go knock on the door, you know what I mean, to this crib, you know what I mean? See what crib this is and see what joints they got in here. Some joints in here, man. So, you know what I mean? DJ Ken Cut, as always, yours truly, Sammy Cook, behind the camera, my man Jazz.
Yes.
And we about to break, as a matter of fact, hey, yo, Jazz, man, you always behind the camera, man. Let me get the camera this time, man. You know what I'm saying? You hold it down today, man. All you know what I'm saying?
Hold up.
Jazz gonna be in front this time, man. Let's go. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, DJ Jazz, set it off.
It's me, Jazz, aka DJ Cut Precise, in front of the camera for a change. You know, we decided to flip the script a little bit. We're gonna go in here, knock on the door, see who's behind these doors, and see what gems they have. So come on with us as we take this musical journey.
Rock the spot, man. Come on, man. Yo, rock the spot, where we going, man? Where we going? Going this way, follow me, good brothers. Oh man, that's what we're laughing. Welcome to my humble vinyl stash. What's up, the vinyl jump, man? Vinyl, vinyl, yeah. Oh, once again, Crate Raiderz crew back in the building.
Yes, sir.
Got my man Rock the Spot, you know what I mean, holding it down with the Crate Raiderz today.
What's happening?
We're gonna dig through his collection, see what's happening, and show you some treats.
So let the show begin.
So how long you been collecting, man?
Truth be told, probably about 10 years. I've been a music lover since I was a little young whippersnapper, but you know, collecting music and vinyl and going shopping for records, about 10 years.
What made you get into it?
At one point, I start experimenting and listening to different type of music as opposed to just what you hear on the radio. And once I got a taste of different genres, that made me explore more in the record store and find out, you know, where this come from, what's that? And I would go to a record store down 4th and South, they closed now, and we'll hear different type of genres, and it piqued my interest, and it made me want to dig, you know, to find out more about the artists and the type of genres that I heard.
Okay.
Well, I'm gonna dive deep, man. I'm just ready to just dive right in.
Right on.
Can you remember the first record you bought?
It was either Bugging Out by Whistle or the Fat Boys album. It was one of the two. I don't remember which one it was. I was probably like 11 years old.
Wow.
And I went on the Ave. And bought either Whistle or Fat Boys first time.
Wow, there you go. That's old school right there.
Yeah.
Let's set it off. I said, you got what'd be one of your top three?
Like I started off by saying, I like different genres of music, and I started to, even though I can't understand a word of Portuguese, I love like Brazilian music. So I heard this one joint, this particular joint right here, the break on it. Just caught me when I heard it, and when I saw it, I had to buy it because I was searching for it forever. I don't even know how to pronounce this brother's name, man. But I tell you, the joint on here is called Alpha Mega, and it's the joint that if you had any party, you definitely going to get her. And even though you don't know what in the world they saying.
Just a soulful jam.
No, it's not even soulful. It's up tempo. It make the track want to start breaking or something.
Oh.
Let's check it out.
You got it.
Let's get into this.
Ooh, ah, now for mega baptismo. Somato psicopneumático. Anal for mega baptismo. Somato psicopneumático. Que também significa.
There you have it. I don't know what to say, but it's dope.
Valacio? That's what we came to the conclusion. His last name is Valacio from Salvador Bahia. Yeah. From Brazil.
So I'm feeling the bass line in that day.
Same here. That's why when I first heard it, I think it was on a B-boy like CD or somewhere.
Yeah, I can see it being on there.
And I said, yo, that thing right there, I need that in my collection. Even if I don't play it, because I buy a lot of records that I don't even play out.
Word.
You know, that I just enjoy, you know, as a music lover, just play in the crib.
Right. Mm-hmm. So how'd you feel when you came across it, right?
Yo, when I saw it, I was like a little kid. Like some records, I'm sure, as y'all diggers, you'll see a record, you'll get excited because you haven't seen it and you've been looking for it. Yo, I like my jaws dropped, like, oh my god. Because I know it wasn't going to last long, so I grabbed it and then that was it. That's history. Yeah.
How long you had it?
At least 3 years.
Okay.
Yeah, at least 3 years.
Okay,
and I've been,
okay,
you know, sitting on it and just staying in the collection for whenever, you know, it just had the opportunity to play it out.
As you know, we are the Crate Raiderz.
That's correct.
Part of the thing we do, we like to dig into other people's collection and see what they have.
No problem.
Cut.
I see some right there. I want to see what's the story behind this. This is right. So, but hey.
So Wild Magnolias. Magnolias, I apologize. They're a group out of New Orleans. And I found out through Personified, who's down with the Little Big Things crew, because he used to live in New Orleans. And he put me down with him. And I will tell you a story about this record. This young lady I know moved into her grandmother's house, and she said, this record's in the basement. Just come take them. I don't care. You know, you don't got to pay me X, Y, Z. I said, no problem. there were plenty of, you know, little joints that were real trash. I seen the cover. I never heard of them. I seen the cover. I said, I need this. And then Polydor, you knew it had to be heat on there. So when I came home, played it.
Rocdaspot got soul.
That's right, brother.
Just made my day right there.
Right there,
brother. Wow, man, this is a true classic.
Yes, sir.
You
put that back in here.
Yeah.
There you go.
Ooh, and the story behind it, man. Timeless, precious, man. Wow.
Yeah, they, as I stated, from New Orleans, so they got roots with the Meters, and you know they be rocking out down there.
Man, this made my day, man.
I'm glad it did, man.
Yeah, it's hot. All right, Jazz, the only thing that
you still
yeah, man, a little mic, man. This makes you want to go, makes you want to go off digging, man.
I can dig
something
it,
that makes you want to go digging.
Yes, sir.
And I just remember the song from the Ultimate Bricks and Beats.
Mm-hmm.
But now I know the original artist, and you know what I mean? I know what to do, you know?
When you see it, you grip that thing.
There you go. Jazz, man, since you up in the spot, why don't you go find something, man? See what you can pull out. All
right. Woo!
Wow.
Tell me about this one, man.
This joint right here, J-Lib versus J-Rock. I think both of them just did a mix, but each of their mixes on one side is J-Lib, one side is J-Rock. And I came across this through a dealer that I go to. You know, everybody got a secret dealer right now, man. So he blessed me with this. He hit me because it's kind of rare, but you know, I had to grab it, and it's heat. It's something new. It blends different songs already into the you know, the 45, but it's that heat, that hip hop heat. Is a continuation. They just made a mix dedicated to J Dilla, all his beats. They blended them up all from one side to the next side. Continuous bangers.
On the 45.
Yes, sir.
45 mixtape.
Exactly. That's exactly what it is. It's my man. He hit me for a couple of dollars on it, but you know, might never come across this again.
Yeah.
Ever.
Limited edition. Let's
get to the second piece, man.
Let's get to the second piece, man. Woo.
Try not to stay in the Brazilian lane, but this song right here, I remember just playing a record when I was cooking one night, and come to find out, I was reading the credits, Stevie Wonder did a couple joints on there. The song is called Real Thing.
Behind this, bro.
I seen that record plenty of times when I was out digging, and then one day I just like, let me just give it a try. And I played it, and I was cooking one day, just put it on the record, and just let it go all the way through, and I fell in love with it. And when I was digging, I looked on the back of the credits and found out Stevie Wonder did at least 2 to 3 tracks on there. So I knew that it had to be official. That's what drew me into buying the album and piqued my interest. And it, without a doubt, never failed. The Stevie Wonder joints on there, official.
There you go.
Official. That's the one that you heard. But the first copy I bought, it was scratched. So when I went digging again and found another copy, I had to get it. Because as you can tell and heard, it's this nice dynamite nice joint on there, man. Yeah. Real, yeah.
It's a dynamite. There you go. Dynamite. So, what they hit you for on this joint?
Believe it or not, man, it was in a dollar bin.
Ooh. Dollar bin, you hear that? Works every time.
Dollar bin. So definitely come up. People be sleeping on the dollar bins. That's when you gotta get your fingers dusty, you know?
Yeah.
So long you had it?
I had that for at least 10 years. Yeah, that was one of the first joints I grabbed. And I, you know, been loving it ever since. I still play it when I'm cooking.
What's the cheapest you ever paid for a record?
50 cents.
50 cent? Wow. 50 cent. Cent, dollar bin? You have it 50 all.
Cent. 50 cent. And came up too. Like, just, it was probably a 45.
What's the most you ever paid for a record?
One, I almost lost my mind one day. I almost paid $200 to $300 for a record, but I didn't. I think the most I paid was 60, and I was out, no, 80. And this was in my, I guess, beginning digging stages when I'm trying to venture out and learn more from DJs I know. I took a trip with Luke Rawls, Black the Ninth, and Froze One.
Wow.
And they,
that's deep digging right there.
Yeah, they know they music. So me being a student, I said, sure, I'll roll up. We went one Saturday morning, came across this Brazilian record that I heard the song somewhere on a compilation. And when I saw the record, I froze because I'm like, oh shit. I had to grab it. And it was $80 because of, I guess it was, you know, an import.
Yeah.
So I grabbed that.
For the love of vinyl.
Yeah, exactly.
Can't go wrong with a love of vinyl.
Exactly.
Wow. So Jazz, you want to get into something over there?
Yeah, let me do a little digging. What's the deal with this one? Where'd you cop that at?
It could have been, what was it? I don't think it was in New York. It was a Philly record store, but I don't remember which one. But what I do remember, when I first heard this, one of these songs on here, one of our good DJ brothers played it. And I bugged out when I heard it. And my digging, my eyes, my ears, I was on the hunt. And the song is called Bad Trip.
I'm gonna trip. I'm gonna real bad trip. I'm gonna trip. I'm gonna real bad trip. You see, I like to travel. So I took myself a trip. I took my head along and left my body.
There we go. Lee Fields. I picked this because of the cover. You know, police, rainy night, you know, something gotta be wrong. But this record is all right. It's banging. Yeah,
that's a dope track right there. Well, how did you feel after you grabbed that joint? Like,
it was a rush. I was excited. And when I got home, because that was the only record I knew off the album. But when I got home and played it, it's more bangers on here, man.
Way more heat on that joint.
More heat. And it's something, you know, just you could let just play in the crib, or you could take out and have people's head just about to fall off and bang it. You know what I mean?
Cool. Them drums is not, man. Them drums right there.
Yeah, it sound like paper thin. That's what, you know what I mean? Drums. My man Jazz said.
Let's continue this. Let's go on to your third piece. You know what I mean?
This is something that I just picked up probably last week or 2 weeks ago.
Ooh.
And I'm big on covers, like hearing joints that, you know, somebody freaked or redid. And when I came across this, I said I need to take this home. Never heard of it. Day of My Life, the new Don Ellis Band Goes Underground, featuring Patty Allen. Okay. And when my man placed the song on it, I'm placed the needle on the record of a remake of It's Your Thing.
Oh, let's check this out.
Yes, sir.
It's your thing. Do what you wanna do. Hey, hey, hey. Cause I can't tell you who the suck is you. It's your thing. Do what you wanna do. Hey, hey, hey. Cause I can't tell you who the suck is you. If you want me to love you, then maybe I will. Believe me, honey.
Have it, it's your thing.
It's your thing.
The new Don Ellis Band Goes Underground.
I'm going deep underground.
Digging.
Look at the back. I guess that's them as children.
And there you go. Hey, not for sale.
Not
promo.
For sale.
Promo. Not for sale.
What's up,
brother? See, when he dropped the needle on that joint, he was like,
whew. Yo, he said, yo, you gotta hear this. I said, all right. He played it.
It was a rap.
Yeah, it's like, damn, I ain't coming here to spend too much money today, but that's how it is when you're going to a record store, man. Yes, sir.
I keep looking over your shoulder, and I keep looking at this record for some reason.
Yamakazuki.
So what's the deal behind this?
Well, it has, let me see, it's a song on there that sampled before it. I can't remember the name of the song, but there's another song on there that blows it out the water. And I saw that in the, when I was digging, and I had to grab that. That was kind of pricey too, but it wasn't 60, but it was pricey, and it was worth it.
So you knew what you was grabbing, right?
Yes, I did.
And you stumbled on something else.
Mm-hmm. Because I was going for one song, and then came up on another joint. Spain. I believe there was a version made in Japan and a version made in Spain. And this is the Spain version. Yeah. Year came out? I'm not sure. But
so yeah. When you dropped it on that track, it was like,
what the? Oh, it was a rap.
Like what the?
Boom, sh- boom, boom.
So it's like some theme music or something, you know what I'm saying?
A head nod joint.
Boom, boom, boom. Alright, we chillin' my man, rock the spot, you know what I'm saying? What more can I say, man? He pulled out some soulful joints for you today, Crate Raiderz crew, DJ Kid Cut, my man Jazz, DJ Jazz, rock the spot into the building. Thanks for having us come through.
Thanks.
My man Sammy Cook behind the camera, keep that camera rolling. See y'all later, man. We about to raise some more of these crates, man.
Peace. Get this back.